Hey everybody, it's been a real long time. I never done a video like for like a real long time, but I'm gonna do a very special video I'm gonna do today to celebrate the 30th anniversary of the new adventures of Pippi Longstocking. And I'm gonna review the storybook of the film because it has like some rare photos of it. And this is the front of the book, and this is the back of the book. And I'm going to show you some of the rare photos of the book. This is the first page. And that's right there. This is the characters of the film right there. We see Pippi Longstocking, Tommy and Annika, her father, Tommy, and her horse, Alfonso, in that one. There's also lots of real photos that has a lot of good books right there. Lots of photos about like the same as from the story right there. But I know the plot of the story is when while Pippi and her father, while they're sailing together, when a storm came and they washed over her father and Pippi overboard and they went to their separate ways. And then Pippi and Alfonso and Mr. Nelson, they were swept away in the on a raft and they flowed into a town. And then they found where they go live in Villa Kula. And then we introduced to Tommy and Annika. Kanika, they were so curious about the house right there. And later on that night, when they were while their parents were out, and they decided to go and investigate it at the house because maybe there was a ghost in that house. And there they are, investigating. And they found out who the ghost is, Pippi Longstocking. And then she found out why Pippi is staying there, because her father fell overboard, but he went to an island that he became a cannibal king. And there's a good photo together right there. And then later on, lawn at night, because when they're making a midnight pancake right there, but her father caught them in the middle of the act, and there they are, all messy. And then the next day, when Tommy and Annika get a little visit from Pippi Longstocking, and then there they are, skating around, scrubbing floors, kind of like they're roller skating for scrub day. And also in that one, we introduced to the three villains right there, Mr. Blackheart and his henchmen, but they're not kind of like Thunder Carlson and Bloom in the film right there, because they wanted to buy the house and destroy it to have like his own like good place right there. And then later on, when Tommy, Annika, and Pippi, they go to town together. When they meet the kids from the orphanage, they're gonna get their haircuts at a barbershop. And then all of a sudden, when Pippi used her gold coins to buy some toys and everything for the kids right there, and ice cream right there, and there they are having a big parade right there. And then they gave them all ice cream with Pippi's gold coins. But the one who was not really happy is Miss Bannister, who runs the orphanage. And then, when they got back home, they drive around, and Pippi drives around with her motorcycle, and then they went flying over the town! And a couple of days, and the very next day, when Miss Bannister arrived at the Villa Vilcula to tell Pippi to go to an orphanage, is to spend with chair, but Pippi didn't want to because he has her monkey and horse there. And also, Mr. Blackheart henchmen's men came to impersonate as a veterinarian. They're trying to get her monkey and her horse, sure, and away from her, but no. And later on that night, when we see Pippi was invited to dinner at Tommy Anka's house, but look at that, She put her cake on her face. That is no good manners to have a good dinner and dessert right there. But Tommy and Annika, they were not happy about they're going to send Pippi to an orphanage right there. But they had to do something drastic. Like, during that time when Pippi meets Jake, the pilot, who also has an autogyro row with his own helicopter right there. And then Pippi and Jake, they're up all night and they build like a wooden auto, like an autogyro. And then when Tommy and Annika wanted to run away with Pippi, and all of a sudden, she has her all jar, and they went flying out of there, flying over the cops, firefighters, and Miss Bannister. Her. And then, and at night, when they were at a, when they put a camp right there, and then Pippi has a gun. Because that she hunts lions, tigers, and cannibals. While Tommy and Annika were all alone when Pippi was taking a nap in the tent, and they heard rustling noise, they were so scared about it. And then they heard a loud roar, and then Pippi gets her guns out, and then she just imitates gunshot, go poof. And then they dream they want to be like pirates together, like Pippi. And then they have a little midnight snack as a chocolate bar. And then they all went to sleep. But in the middle of the night, when Mr. Settigrate, Tommy Anka's father, to go to Jake's all pilot store, and then they went to the had to find Tommy Anka and Pippi in it. And then they decided to fly to find them. And there they are right there. And the next day, when they're wooden plane, they're about to sink. And then Pippi and Tommy Anka decided to go for a little swim before breakfast. And all of a sudden, when a cow came and ate Tommy Anka's clothes all the bushes. And then had to find some of the like anything to wear the clothes in. And so they decided to walk on by, and then they found wooden barrels of it, and then they float on a river. But all of a sudden, right there, they're heading close to a waterfall. Before they fell down, before they getting close to the waterfall, Jake and Mr. Settigrate came to the rescue and dropped the ladder. And at the middle, when they went back home, when we see Miss Bannister confronting Pippi. Pippi, the teller, you're going to come to the children's home with us. Just try. Just till Christmas. And then the next day, or a couple of days later, when Pippi was sent to an orphanage, because she was not happy about her uniform to look like a private school. Especially the strict teacher, Miss Megasmith, who was not a fan of Pippi Longstocking. When she's trying to tell her the math question, she got like a silly wrong answer, and then she put her in timeout. But Pippi was not happy about it. And then the next day, when she got a little mishaps again, and then she decided to make a drawing of a horse on the floor. But the head girl, who called caught in the act, and tell Miss Smith about it, and then she gave her a punishment at a sweatbox. And then we cut to the dormitory when she looked out the window when she sees a cloud, the whole cloud, when she talks to her late mother who was up in heaven. Yeah, she was up in heaven. But she still misses her papa. And then she was trying to get a message in a bottle for her of it. And then later on that night, right when Pippi's trying to escape, and then when she meets a strange man who had lots of cans on it, and his name was Gregory the Glue Man. You see him right there with lots of cans of glue right there? And then she tried to climb up on the walls like he did. And then, when she wrote a message to Bottle, and Pippi decided to climb down, when she tried to climb down to the wall, and all of a sudden she got stuck, and then she took her shoes off and jumped off. And then she ran to the beach and threw the message in the bottle into the ocean. When she was going back, and all of a sudden she sees an orange glow above the town. And then she saw red. Yeah, let me try this again. When Pippi whispers, when she slowly turns from the beach, and then she saw with horror that in the sky were red flames, at the orphanage is on fire. Look. Even. Because the glue man and two little children were stuck in the fire. And so the glue man jumped off with the fire safety mattress, and then Pippi decided to save the two little kids, and then she used a rope to walk over it with the help of Mr. Nilsson. And everybody calls Pippi a hero. And then she vows to go back to Villa Vilkula. And then back at home, it was Christmas. But I know that she misses her papa so much. Look at that. Still misses her papa. And then, and all the townspeople pay a little visit to Pippi, before respect. And then Miss Banster and the head girl gave her a very special present, and they gave her a puppy for Christmas. When Tommy and could visit Pippi to have a good Christmas right there, and all of a sudden they heard a voice saying, "Life is a breeze, we live it for fun, no apologies to anyone, we live on the seas." And then it was her father alive and reunited with Pippi to have a great Christmas. And then why did you survive from the island? That you became like a Campbell King or something? And then Pippi made a crown for him. And there he is as the Cannibal King. But the one thing to bring back to have like a sorry. And the one thing she has to get back at the island to have a princess named Pippi Longstocking. And then a couple of days later, when they're about to say goodbye to everyone, but the one who they were not happy is Tommy Anka. But they were so sad that Pippi is leaving. And I know that she decided, but Pippi decided to when Pippi decided to stay at the Villa Vilkula with Tommy Anka. And school, too. And Papa says, "Children need a little order in their life." And Pippi says, "Especially they can order themselves." And then, when Pippi Alphonse Miss Nelson jumped off the hop toad ship, and then they swam to the beach, where she reunited with Pippi, when she reunited with Tommy Anka. And then she said, and then Papa says, "Maybe next time, Pippi, I'm so glad to stay. But whatever you need me, you know how to reach me." And then, and that's how the story ends of the film right there. I'm really like the reason to celebrate the film is, like, this is the book I got on Amazon like a long time ago. And before I got the book, I finally got the Blu-ray of the film. But also I did a little Blu-ray opening preview to the film of it for the first time ever I found, because it also had the original widescreen format. But everything was like a little same from the first DVD release from from Chloe tries to home video of it. Because I'm really like to celebrate the 30th anniversary, and a shout out to the real Pippi Longstocking actress, Tammy Erin, for it. And Tammy, I really hope you're watching this video, but I'm going to give a very special shout out to you. Because you know that you are like the best Pippi Longstocking fan, because I grew up watching Pippi Longstocking when I was like very little, when I saw it on HBO Family for the first time. And then I watched it again over and over again, on DVD when I was like 8 years old, when my mom got the DVD. Because I really loved the film so much. Mostly I read the books a little bit. And I really hope you're enjoying, you guys, this video. If you want to subscribe to my channel, click the bell button for notifications. If you want to see my other videos, where I have made a little bit of crossover videos and other ones of it, and I really hope you're enjoying this video for a very special anniversary of the film. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye!